Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the second part of second week of August. This is the second part, so if you have not seen the first part, then please see the first part of second week. Total number of questions were 200. In the first video, I covered around 100 questions, and in this video also, I will cover around 100 questions. So only one day is missing, 14th of August, that I will cover in the third week video. Otherwise, the video would have been, very long. If you are preparing for SSC CGL, CHSL, Bank PO, Clerk, UPSC, then our pen drive courses and test series are available. You have to go to our website for more details, or you can dial any of the three numbers given here. 958-004-8004, 729-105-9476 or 011-413-2-3204. So here we go. Which state is going to grant land rights to the slum dwellers living in urban areas so that they can have some security with respect to their habitat? So which state will grant land rights to these people? This state is the state of Odisha. It approved promulgation of two ordinances for the same. And Odisha's chief minister is Navin Patnaik. Governor is Dr. S.C. Jamir. Odisha has two very important places when it comes to Wildlife Sanctuary National Park. One is called Simlipal and second is called Bhitarkanika. Bhitarkanika. There is a beach called Gahirmatha Beach, which is famous for olive ridley turtles. These are very, very important. Olive ridley turtles. And Odisha, capital of Odisha is Bhubaneswar, which recently hosted Asian Athletics Championship. Three Indian companies have featured in the top 100 of the Forbes World's Most Innovative Companies 2017. Which of the following is not one of these companies? So Asian Paint is there. Then Hindustan Lever is there. TCS is not there. TCS is IT company, information technology company. It is India's largest IT company and Bharti Airtel. So Asian Paints, you should know the ranking also. Hindustan Lever is ranked 7th, Asian Paint is 8th, and Airtel is 78th. If they ask you which is the most innovative company of the world, it is salesforce.com. And earlier it was Tesla, which manufactures electric cars. Sifiso Lungelo Thebete passed away recently. He was a famous what? So he was from South Africa. Remember that. South Africa's president is Jacob Zuma. South Africa is important for us because it is a member of BRICS. So he was a famous bodybuilder. Bodybuilder. Which Indian wrestler has won bronze medal in the Greco-Roman category at the Junior World Wrestling Championship? Junior World Wrestling Championship took place at Tampere. Tampere is in Finland. Capital of Finland is Helsinki. His name is Sajan. BJP politician Samwar Lal Jat, he passed away. He was a member of parliament of Lok Sabha from which constituency? He was from Ajmer. And this is significant because in 2014 general elections, he beat in the elections Sachin Pilot, who is a tall Congress leader. India is going to conduct joint military exercise called Yudh Abhyas in September with which country? Yudh Abhyas we do with America. Who is our now relations between America and India are at an all-time high, and this will take place in America with America. This exercise started in 2004, and if they ask which Indian soldiers will participate, so 200 Indian soldiers from Gorkha Rifles will participate. Gorkha Rifles. So remember that, USA. And and with Russia we do Indra. With France we do, one is Shakti and the second one is Varun. Which space agency has announced to launch a full-fledged niche Earth observation satellite called Hyperspectral Imaging Satellite or HISIS? Hyperspectral Imaging Satellite or HISIS. HISIS is a product of ISRO, although they have not specified the date yet, but this is by ISRO. ISRO is Indian Space Research Organization. ISRO's chairman is A.S. Kiran Kumar. And one of ISRO's former chairmen passed away recently, Professor Udupi Rao, U.R. Rao, who was a Padam Vibhushan awardee. He received Padam Vibhushan earlier this year. ISRO is headquartered in Bengaluru. NASA is American Space Agency and it is headquartered in Washington, D.C., the same place where we have the headquarter of World Bank and IMF both. Now, NASA is launching two missions, Juno for Jupiter and Cassini for Saturn. CNSA is Chinese Space Agency and JAXA is Japanese Aeronautical Space Exploration Agency of Japan. One more thing you remember, NASA and ISRO, together they are launching a satellite called NISAR. ONGC Videsh is planning to invest $150 million in exploration this fiscal. In which country, basically? ONGC Videsh is investing $150 million in Colombia, Kazakhstan, and Bangladesh. So the answer is all of the above. Colombia is a South American country. Capital is Bogota. Kazakhstan capital is Astana. Bangladesh capital is Dhaka. Sheikh Hasina is the Prime Minister. Now remember, ONGC till last year, it was the most profitable public sector undertaking in India. But this year, Indian Oil Corporation has replaced ONGC as the most profitable public sector company in India. So remember all these facts which I have told you about ONGC. It is a Maharatan company and its chairman is Dinesh Saraf. Dinesh Saraf. Which team has won the 2017 FA Community Shield? It is played between the winner of the FA Cup in England and the winner of the English Premier League. So English Premier League was won by Chelsea and FA Cup was won by Arsenal. So it was a match between Arsenal and Chelsea. So Chelsea was beaten by Arsenal. The manager of Arsenal is this guy. His name is Arsene Wenger and the manager of Chelsea is called Conte. He is from Italy. Which state has tied up with Microsoft to use its artificial intelligence based Mine platform to screen children for eye problems? Now Mine itself, the full form is Microsoft Intelligent Network for Eye Care. And which state has partnered? It is the state of Telangana. Incidentally or coincidentally, Telangana's capital is Hyderabad and Microsoft CEO is also from Hyderabad. His name is Satya Nadella. Who has been appointed as the secretary to the newly elected Vice President of India, Venkaiya Naidu? Venkaiya Naidu, he saw out the competition from GK Gandhi, Gopal Krishna Gandhi, and he emerged the winner in the election of the Vice Presidential post. He is the 13th Vice President of India and Ramnath Kovind is the 14th President of India, right? So who is the secretary? Secretary is Mr. Subba Rao. And remember that the first Vice President of India was Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, who did 2 terms as Vice President. And after that, Hamid Ansari did 2 terms as Vice President. And in between, nobody did 2 terms as Vice President. Now, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, who was the first Vice President of India, his birthday is celebrated on 5th September as National Teachers Day. But World Teachers Day is observed on 5th of October. In India, we celebrate Teachers Day on 5th of September. That is the difference. Which differently abled athlete, para athlete, won the silver medal in the javelin throw at the World Under 20 Para Athletics Championship in Nottwil in Switzerland. Switzerland has a lot of important cities like Zurich, like Geneva, which has headquarters of WHO and a lot of other organizations. And the capital of Switzerland is Bern, B-E-R-N-E. And there is a very important player from Switzerland, tennis player. His name is Roger Federer. He is the greatest tennis player. He has won 19 Grand Slams. So I'm talking here about Rinku Hooda, who is from Rohtak in Haryana. Who won the men's single title in the City Open at the Washington DC? Who won? His name is Alexander Zverev. Alexander Zverev, he became the youngest champion of the City Open tennis. Which bank has announced to offer debit card at a special price of only Rs. 99 for the first year for customers who will open account under the zero balance account scheme? This bank is Kotak Mahindra Bank and its managing director is Uday Kotak. Lok Sabha recently passed a bill to replace an ordinance promulgated in May related to which of the following? Now ordinance is passed when the parliament is not in session. So in May parliament was not in session, but these days we are having the monsoon session of the parliament. So this was related to non-performing asset in the banks which have been accumulating and which has forced the RBI to take up drastic measures. Now also note that this ordinance allowed the Reserve Bank of India to initiate the insolvency and bankruptcy procedures. It made RBI more powerful in insolvency procedures. Securities and Exchange Board of India, Ajay Tyagi is the chairman of SEBI. SEBI has put, it is a capital market regulator by the way, so it has put restrictions on trading in how many suspected shell companies, total number of companies is 331. Which state assembly, Vidhan Sabha, recently passed the Religious Freedom Bill 2017, which aims to stop the forced religious conversion? This was done by Jharkhand Vidhan Sabha or Jharkhand Legislative Assembly. And Jharkhand CM is Raghubar Das and Governor is Draupadi Murmu. And Raghubar Das is the first non-tribal chief minister of Jharkhand. So remember that. Which team has won the 2017 UEFA Super Cup that was held in Skopje in Macedonia? Macedonia. So UEFA Super Cup was played between the UEFA Champions League winner and the Europa Cup winner. So UEFA Champions League winner was Real Madrid, and Europa Cup League winner was Manchester United. Manchester United is the richest club, football club in the world. So Real Madrid beat Manchester United in the final of the UEFA Super Cup. And who is the coach of Real Madrid is an important question. His name is Zidane. He was a former player from France. Manchester United coach is Jose Mourinho, who played as a defender for Portugal. In a first among IITs, which IIT has launched a daycare facility for their researchers and faculty? So those faculty who have children can now be provided daycare. And around 40 children can be accommodated in this daycare. This has been done by IIT Delhi. Which company has launched virtual customer service model initiative in India? I repeat, virtual customer service model initiative. This company is Amazon. Donald Trump tweeted against Amazon yesterday, which led to decrease in its valuation by $5 billion in just one day. Amazon chairman is Jeff Bezos. And Jeff Bezos became the richest person in the world for one day, replacing Microsoft's Bill Gates for just one day. Which state government is going to raise $270 million from the Green Climate Fund, which is set up under United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, which was a result of the 1992 Rio Earth Summit? Very, very important. This state is Maharashtra. And they will spend it on the Jal Yukt Shivar Yojana, which is basically to fill up all the water resources, because Maharashtra, a lot of areas are drought stricken. So remember this. So Maharashtra, it has a BJP government. C. Vidyasagar Rao is the governor, who is also the governor of Tamil Nadu. And Maharashtra's chief minister is Devendra Fadnavis, who has become the first Indian to qualify for the world championship in javelin throw. Athletics world championship will be in London. And he has become the first Indian to qualify in the javelin throw category. His name is Davinder Singh Kang. Eighth meeting took place of Regional Technical Group on Trade, Commerce and Investment CBM of the Heart of Asia, Istanbul process. Where was this meeting recently held? It was held in New Delhi and it was attended by 17 countries. Who has been awarded the Hugo Award for the Best Novel 2017 at a ceremony that was held in the capital of Finland, Helsinki? Hugo Award is the best award, I mean most prestigious award in the science fiction category. And she has become the first woman to win the Hugo Award for Best Novel 2 times in a row. Her name is Nora Jemisin. Which Indian-American has been appointed by President Donald Trump as chairman of the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission? All these Indians who are at important positions should be remembered. His name is Neil Chatterjee. Donald Trump's daughter Ivanka Trump is coming to India in an entrepreneurship initiative. And Donald Trump's wife is Melania Trump. Donald Trump's party is Republican Party. And vice president is Mike Pence, P-E-N-C-E. Mike Pence. Commerce Minister is Nirmala Sitharaman. So Commerce Ministry has initiated the process of shutting down which of the following subordinate offices? These offices are no more required because the government will procure through the government e-marketplace, that is electronic government e-marketplace platform. So no need for now Directorate General of Supplies and Disposals. Who has been appointed as the Managing Director of Export Import Bank of India, which is headquartered in Mumbai? His name is David Raskina. Logistics Data Bank LDB project is going to expand operations to the southern region. Currently, it covers only India's which area? It covers only the Western Corridor. Western Corridor. And now remember that each container will be connected with RFID, just like a lot of toll taxis are there which RFID enabled. And this was unveiled at July 2016 at Jawaharlal Nehru Port in Mumbai. Jawaharlal Nehru Port, which is called Nahawa Shewa. It was devised to ease the traffic on the Mumbai port on the western coast. Which of the following has launched online dictionary in Tamil and Gujarati as part of the special focus on Indian vernacular languages? And it had launched Hindi dictionary also. So this is done by the Oxford Global Languages. Oxford. Lok Sabha recently passed a bill to increase the authorized capital of NABARD to how much amount? In fact, they have increased their authorized capital 6 times. Earlier it was only 5,000 crore, now they have increased to 30,000 crore. NABARD was established in 1982, headquartered in Mumbai. Chairman is Harsh Kumar Bhanwala. Very, very important. Harsh Kumar Bhanwala is the chairman of NABARD. Government has raised 400 crore rupees by selling a stake of how much in Hindustan Copper Limited? This stake is 6.8%. And it sold the shares through the auction on stock exchange. How much additional revenue has Indian Railways earned through the Flexi Fare scheme between September and June 2017? So when the scheme was originally started and till now, total 540 crore is the earning. Flexi fare scheme, what is it? So 10% of the seats will be sold at normal price. After that, every 10% till 50% will have a 10% raise in the cost. And it was launched in September. Till now, 540 crore, and railways really need to make money because it has submitted a loss of 33,000 crore rupees in just 1 year. Railway Minister is Suresh Prabhu. Which bank has tied up with Zeta to offer digital solution for the corporates? This is a direct question. This bank, its CEO is Rajiv Lal. Can you guess the bank? It is headquartered in Mumbai. It is IDFC Bank. Which commodity exchange in India is going to launch India's first options on futures in gold contract? It is the Multi Commodities Exchange, MCX. And who is the managing director of it, MD? His name is Murgank Paranjpe. Murgank Paranjpe. NSDC, National Skill Development Corporation of India, it has partnered with which company to train app developers for Android as well as other web platforms? Mobile platform also and web platform also. This is Google. Google is headquartered in Mountain View, California. It was founded by two people. One is Sergey Brin and other one is Larry Page. Google CEO is an Indian. Sundar Pichai is his name. Researchers from which institute in India, they have developed a highly sensitive nanometer scale carbon monoxide sensor. Carbon monoxide is a very poisonous gas because it combines with hemoglobin and it forms carboxyhemoglobin, thereby reducing the oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, which leads to hypoxia and therefore ischemia, and person dies of suffocation and lack of oxygen. This is Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Who has been appointed as the chairman of Sensor Board, that is Central Board of Film Certification, to replace outgoing Prahlad Nihlani? His name is Prasoon Joshi, who is a two-time National Award winner and also Padma Shri winner. Which bank recently unveiled Bharat QR and BBPS, Bharat Bill Payment System, for digital payment? Which bank subscribed to it? This bank is Canara Bank, which is headquartered in Bengaluru. Recently, 15th meeting of BIMSTEC took place. BIMSTEC are those countries which are in and around the Bay of Bengal. Their foreign ministers meeting took place recently. BIMSTEC, Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation. Where did it take place? It took place where we have the headquarter of SAARC, which is Kathmandu, capital of Nepal. Now, Sher Bahadur Deoba is the Prime Minister of Nepal. He replaced Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachand. Bidya Devi Bhandari is the President. And Nepal is very important ally. There is an area, disputed area between India and Nepal called Kalapani. Maria Sharapova has received a wild card invitation to play at which tournament? She was banned for taking banned substances. She will get a wild card for the China Open. China's capital is Beijing. Xi Jinping is the president and China's currency is yuan. You can also call it renminbi. Which electronic commerce company has launched budding star program for its employees? This company is Flipkart. Flipkart recently released a lot of funding from SoftBank, which is a Japanese telecom company. And Flipkart was founded by the Bansal brothers, Sachin Bansal and Binny Bansal. Now also remember that Flipkart CEO is Kalyan Krishnamurthy. Which team has won the 91st MCC Murugappa Gold Cup hockey tournament? This is ONGC. And who is the chairman? Dinesh Saraf. Government has devised or formulated National Trade Facilitation Action Plan for implementation of World Trade Organization's Trade Facilitation Agreement. It will be implemented in which year? It will be implemented throughout the years 2017 to 20. So these 4 years it has formulated the National Trade Facilitation Action Plan. Gyan Singh Sohanpal, he passed away. He was a leader of which political party? He was elected to the West Bengal Assembly 10 times. So he was from Congress party. Which state government has launched an awareness drive called Namami Gange Jagriti Yatra? Ganga takes its origin from Uttarakhand in Uttarkashi from Gomukh, that is the Gangotri Glacier, and it passes through then all the other states, UP, Bihar, Jharkhand and West Bengal, and finally it goes to Bangladesh also. So which state I am talking about? I am talking about Uttar Pradesh, which has the longest course of the Holy Ganges. And this awareness will be in about 25 districts from Bijnor to Balia. SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, has entered into a pact, an agreement with the Securities and Exchange Organization of which country? Like we have SEBI, which country's capital market regulator it has partnered with? They have partnered with Iran. Capital is Tehran. Currency is Riyal. Hassan Rouhani is the president. And we are building a port called Chabar in Iran. We are also investing in a port called Trincomalee in Sri Lanka. India's first microforest is going to be built in which state? Microforest. Which state in India has the maximum forest cover? It is Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh has a lot of important national parks also, like Bandhavgarh, Panch, Panna, Kanha, you know, one Vihar, etc. So the answer to this question is Chhattisgarh. Chhattisgarh was cut out from Madhya Pradesh. Chhattisgarh capital is Naya Raipur, and Chhattisgarh Balram Das Tandon is the governor and Dr. Raman Singh is the chief minister. Which country recently sent an unbreakable code from its satellite to the earth using the world's first quantum satellite? This was done by China. China have a very important rocket which is called Long March. Long March. And remember the name of this experiment also, it is called QS. It is a satellite name. So the, in the exam they can ask you, QUESS is the satellite of which country? The answer is China. National Mission for Clean Ganga. It is by the Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation headed by Uma Bharti. Recently approved 10 projects in Bihar, West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh worth how much amount? Total amount is 2000 crore rupees. World's oldest man, Israel Kristal, he passed away. He was a Holocaust survivor. He had escaped from the concentration camp. So he was a Holocaust survivor of the Auschwitz concentration camp in Germany. So he passed away in the city of Haifa in Israel. And Haifa is the same city, you know, Teen Murti Marg in Delhi. It is proposed to, his name will be renamed after the Haifa city in Israel. So he was 113 years old. He was a Guinness World Record holder for longest surviving person. And also remember one thing. Israel capital is Jerusalem. President is Reuven Rivlin. Prime Minister is Benjamin Netanyahu. Which cab aggregator company has recently raised 231 crore rupees from Techne Private Ventures through issue of preference shares? And the person in the picture is Bhavish Agarwal. He is the CEO of Ola. With reference to medium-term expenditure framework settlement MTEF tabled in the parliament recently, India's tax to GDP ratio is expected to rise to how much percent by 2019-20? India's tax to GDP ratio will be 11.9%, and 11.3% will be in 2017-18, that is the current fiscal, and 11.6% in the next fiscal, that is 2018-19, and finally in the last year it will be 11.9%. Which Bollywood actress has become the first female to hoist the Indian national flag at the Indian Film Festival of Melbourne, which is annual day celebration of the Independence Day? Her name is Aishwarya Rai Bachchan, wife of Abhishek Bachchan. And can you tell me what is the name of Aishwarya Rai Bachchan's daughter? Write down in the name in comments. SoftBank Group, which is a Japanese telecom company, it has announced to make an investment of how much amount in Flipkart? The total amount they are investing is $2.5 billion, which is around 15,000 crore rupees. Which Indian cricketer has claimed the top spot in the International Cricket Council test rankings for all-rounders? His name is Ravindra Jadeja. Ravindra Jadeja. And second is Shakib Al Hasan of Bangladesh. Iran has signed its biggest ever car deal with which French automobile manufacturer to produce 1.5 lakh cars. This is the biggest ever deal in the history of Iran. And this car manufacturer is Renault. One of the cars of Renault is very popular in North India. It is called Duster. And Peugeot is a company which bought Ambassador car from India. It's also a French company. AICTE has announced that those engineering colleges will be shut down which have below what percentage of occupancy. So all the engineering colleges in India which have less than 30% occupancy, they will be shut down. There were 27 lakh vacant seats in India. Can you believe it this year in engineering colleges? 27 lakh vacant seats. And total there are 10,350 engineering colleges in India. As per the survey conducted by the Quality Council of India, which state has the lowest toilet coverage at only 30%? It is Bihar. And if they ask maximum toilet coverage, Haryana and Kerala, they both have 99% toilet coverage, followed by Sikkim at 97%. Sikkim, by the way, is also the first state to become open defecation free. And Kerala and Haryana. Haryana Chief Minister is Manohar Lal Khattar, Governor is Kaptan Singh Solanki, and Kerala's Governor is Mr. Satashivam, P. Satashivam, and Chief Minister is Pinaray Vijayan. Which instant messaging company has acquired tech startup called Cryo? It is a company headquartered in Bengaluru. The name is Hike Messenger. And who is the CEO of Hike? Kevin Bharti Mittal. SEBI has recently launched an online registration mechanism for what? This they have launched for custodians. Custodians. This will allow better transparency and less regulatory fillings. It will be done in a cost-effective manner. Lok Sabha recently passed State Banks Repeal and Amendment Bill 2017 to repeal and amend which old acts? It is the SBI Subsidiary Banks Act 1959, 56 and 55. Answer is all of the above. Six banks have merged with State Bank of India. State Bank of Bikaner, Jaipur, Hyderabad, Mysore, Patiala, Travancore and Bharatiya Mahila Bank. Who released the book Khushwant Singh in Wisdom and in Jest, which is co-authored by Vijay Narayan Shankar and Onkar Singh? It was released by which person? Captain Amrinder Singh, who is the Chief Minister of Punjab. Which Indian IT giant is going to acquire Brilliant Basics at an estimated almost 60 crore, 7.5 million pounds? This is our logo of pound. So this will be done by the Infosys company. Infosys CEO Sikka, Vishal Sikka, he has just resigned today. Amazon India has partnered with the handloom and textile department of which state? And they will basically educate, train and enable the weavers and artisans so that they can sell their produce directly on Amazon. And as we know, founder and president and also CEO of Amazon is Jeff Bezos. It is a company headquartered in Seattle, which is in Washington, D.C. So we are talking about Telangana. When was International Day of the World's Indigenous People? It was observed by United Nations. It was observed on August the 9th. And the theme was 10th anniversary of the UN Declaration on the Rights of the Indigenous People. United Nations is headquartered in New York, where we have the headquarters of UNICEF. UN chief is Antonio Guterres from Portugal. Which Indian personality has been honored by the UAE government, United Arab Emirates, capital is Abu Dhabi, with the Community Service Medal? Community Service Medal has been bestowed upon Firoz Merchant. National Green Tribunal, it is chaired by Justice Swatantra Kumar. So National Green Tribunal has put a ban in Delhi on plastic bags of thickness below how much? Thickness below 50 microns will be banned by National Green Tribunal, have been banned. And also remember, National Green Tribunal, and apart from that, there is an organization called Food and Safety Standard Authority of India. It banned the use of stapler pins in the tea bags. And National Green Tribunal earlier also banned manja, that is the kite flying thread coated with glass powder. When was the second round of National Deworming Day? That was held recently. Deworming, especially in children, it's a big issue. So first National Deworming Day was held in February, and more than 11 crore children, 110 million children have been covered under this. So we are talking about August the 10th, when was the second National Deworming Day, and our health minister is JP Nadda. Conseles Kipruto, he became the world 3000 meter steeplechase champion. He is from which country? The capital of this country is Nairobi. This country I'm talking about is Kenya. Which of the following web giant has launched its online video platform called Watch? And this might give some competition to YouTube in the coming days. It is Facebook. COO of Facebook is Sheryl Sandberg. And CEO is Mark Zuckerberg. General Insurance Corporation of India, GICRE. It has recently filed the draft red herring prospectus for its initial public offering. It will raise a capital of how much amount? It is eyeing a capital of 10,000 crore rupees by diluting 14.22% of its of stake. Which of the following two automobile companies recently they have called off their partnership? Earlier they were partnering, now they are not. So this was Tata Motor and Skoda Auto. Skoda Auto, it is the Volkswagen or the Volkswagen group that owns Volkswagen, Skoda and Audi, all the three. In a first, which bank has announced the launch of a fully digital instant credit card service? And a customer can get a credit card instantly with a credit limit of up to 4 lakh rupees on pre-checked bureau scores. This bank is ICICI Bank and chairman is Chanda Kochar, who is the president of ICICI Bank. Board of Control for Cricket in India, it has been given the order by Kerala High Court to lift the ban from which cricketer? He is also a BJP politician. His name is Shri Shant. Which of the following recently adopted a negotiating framework for a code of conduct in the disputed South China Sea? It is between the ASEAN and China. So the answer is 1 and 2. ASEAN has total of 10 countries. Ted Corbett passed away. He was a famous what? He was a very, very renowned sports journalist. Sports journalist. Niti Aayog has selected how many states for its Sustainable Action for Transforming Human Capital Initiative, which is called SAAT. This is very important. Three states will be chosen for medical, three states will be chosen for education, and they will be made the ideal states so that other states can follow these and can grow in their patronage. So total there are six states that are chosen. Niti Aayog is chaired by Pradhan Mantri Modi. Vice chairman is Rajiv Kumar, who replaced Arvind Pangaria. And the CEO is Amitabh Kant. Which are these six states is absolutely important. So, when it comes to healthcare or medical services, three states were chosen. Uttar Pradesh, Assam and Karnataka. When it comes to education, it was Madhya Pradesh, Odisha and Jharkhand. Rinat Sandhu, current ambassador of India to Italy, has been concurrently appointed ambassador of India to which country? So, given additional charge for ambassadorship of San Marino. Capital of San Marino is San Marino, currency is Euro. Italy's capital is Rome, which is the headquarters of Food and Agriculture Organization and United Nations World Food Programme, who has been appointed as Executive Director at the World Bank. Executive Director is S. Aparna, and she will represent the constituency of India, Bangladesh, Bhutan and Sri Lanka. Centre has extended the disturbed area tag on which of the following states under the AFSPA Act? AFSPA Act, now how many more states are put in the disturbed area tag? Armed Forces Special Powers Act, which gives sweeping powers to the Indian forces to carry out search operations and various other things. So this they have done in Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya and Assam. So the answer is all of the above. Assam capital is Dispur, Meghalaya is Shillong and Arunachal Pradesh is Itanagar. Uhuru Kenyatta has been re-elected as the president of which country? He has been re-elected as the president of which country? This country is Kenya, and Kenya, I told one athlete also. Anyways, Kenya capital is Nairobi. Which play written by Garish Khemeni and Akshat Nigam has won the Hindu Playwright Award of 2017, and this award was instituted in 2008 to reward the best new unpublished and unperformed play script in English language. So the name is In Search of Darya Sagar. Which country has announced a visa-free policy for visitors from 80 countries? 80 countries. It is Qatar, which will have the 2022 Football World Cup. Qatar's capital is Doha. Government has approved establishment of Postgraduate Institute for Research in Yoga and Naturopathy in which places? Together, it will be two places, one in Karnataka and one in Haryana. So the answer is 3 and 4. In Karnataka, it will be the Yoga Postgraduate Institute will be established at Nagmangal, and in Haryana, it will be in Jhajjar. And you know that for yoga, we have a separate ministry called Ayush, which is headed by Shripad Yesso Nayak, who is the Minister of State for Ayush with independent charge. A stands for Ayurveda, Y for Yoga, U for Unani, S for Siddha, H for Homeopathy. How much dividend or profit has RBI transferred to the government for the year 2015-16? That is financial year 2016. Total amount is 30,659 crore and RBI's governor is Urjit Patel. Which union ministry has launched a logo designing contest for Women of India Festival? And you know that this ministry is Women and Child Development. It is headed by Maneka Gandhi. Logo designing contest for Women of India Festival. Central Bank of which country has announced not to do away with plastic banknotes made from animal fats? Means the bank of this country has said that if the plastic notes are made from animal fat, then they will not discontinue it. So this has been decided by United Kingdom. And the governor of United Kingdom Central Bank is Mark Carney. Mark Carney, and UK Prime Minister is Theresa May. Which Indian shooter won the gold medal in both the single and the double event at the men's double trap at the 7th Asian Shotgun Championship, which was held in the capital of Kazakhstan, Astana? Kazakhstan also opened its ambassadorial office in Chennai, marking 25 years of ambassador or diplomatic ties with India. Israel also completed 25 years of diplomatic ties with India. His name is Ankur Mittal. First phase of NCCC has been made operational by the government to scan the web traffic in India to detect cybersecurity threats. There was a committee also on cybersecurity threat by RBI, which was called Meena Hemchandra Committee. Meena Hemchandra is one of the executive directors of the Reserve Bank of India. What does NCCC stands for? It stands for National Cyber Coordination Center. National Cyber Coordination Center. So this was the second part of the second week of August multiple choice questions. Lot of questions from banking. In fact, more than 25% questions were from banking and insurance. Thanks for watching and do share the videos.